So.
So Teddy, Hobbles will stand here for a few minutes. And decided to turn the camera on. My advice is always back away from your horse so that you can monitor what his feet are doing. If he goes to move, come to you, you can move, help him. I'm going to stand right there and wait for me. Looks like Hobble up kind of high, just in case he panics. He doesn't stick a hind foot over that rope. If you hobble down low, he might be able to get a hind foot over that rope. If it's up high, he'd have a hard time getting his foot up that high and over. Don't go so far, it makes him worry. Can you think for a minute? There's snow sliding off of the roof. So they're hearing all kinds of outdoor noises here. This is good. Here, reassuring. I love on me. Didn't think. I'll just come back and reassure. But I want you to see why I suggest you never walk away. Watch what he'll do. I'm going to walk away. Watch. I thought he might try to come to me like maybe he thought he was being led away. That's why I like to back away from a horse when I'm trying to teach him to hop. Yeah, just kind of poop. Poop. I'm going to leave him be there. Go grab him. Snow sliding off the roof.
Slabler really come with a vengeance here.
Then a few minutes. If you start to monkey with it, just break his focus. There's nothing messing with that. Pretty soon you'll go to a leather halter or a hobble, so he can't untie himself. But this, you want to be able to get undone in a hurry. It's soft, can't hurt him. But I always want to be able to make sure I can boot their hip just a little, if I have to. Let's go to remind him I can. I want him to be able to move his hip. I want him to stay, keep himself sure. Good. Thank you.